A new ferry service between Maine and Canada could soon be a reality once again. The Premier of Nova Scotia has committed to subsidizing the ferry between Yarmouth, Nova Scotia and Maine. For economic reasons, Bay Ferries Limited stopped operating the cap between Nova Scotia, Portland and Bar Harbor back in 2009. But now some Canadian officials think a new service will be profitable. And tonight's Project Economy Report, News 8's Norm Karkos has a closer look at what this could mean for Maine's economy.
The Premier of Nova Scotia says he is committed to finding a new provider and finding $21 million over 7 years to help get this new ferry service underway. Now, an 80-page report on the revitalization says Portland seems to make the most sense financially, and city leaders agree.
They did recommend Portland because of the cultural activities we have here, the fact that we are a tourist destination, and they recognize the fact that Portland is an up-and-coming city on the cruise ship route.
But the fate of the ferry still hinges on whether officials in Nova Scotia can convince the Canadian federal government to finance the $21 million, plus an additional $13 million to refurbish Yarmouth's terminal facilities. If all goes as planned, Portland could reap the benefits from Canada's investment.
But certainly when you put thousands and thousands of people on the streets or the restaurants or the hotel, it's good for the whole city.
The ferry would actually be more of a cruise-style ship, unlike the high-speed cat, which lost $7 million annually. One local business owner is excited about reviving the service. He thinks the Canadian economy will once again support a ferry, adding that a cruise-style ship is a perfect fit for Portland's downtown.
Portland is ideal for the cruise-type ferry because it's just 10 hours over, 10 hours back, perfect two-hour turnaround, so it's ideal for the operation.
And that same revitalization report says service is unlikely to begin any time before 2014. Here in Portland, Norm Karkos, News 8.